Hi friends, welcome to my channel. This is Gurmeet Kaur and you are watching your channel that is Green Meadows. So today guys, I am here to show you and tell you about this double petal hibiscus. This double petal hibiscus is a very beautiful flower. It is just like hibiscus but growing double petal hibiscus. It is little tougher than hibiscus. Hibiscus is like we can just place it and we'll be getting more number of blooms. But in the double petal hibiscus, what happens, most of the times you'll get the buds but getting the flower is a task. See these buds, they fall off if you don't take care of these buds properly. They fall off. So why do they fall off? So they need to have loads of nutrition. So today we are going to discuss all about the hibiscus. See how my money plant is growing here. Now I need to tie this up. Okay, so today we are going to talk about all things about this double petal hibiscus. See guys, as you can see I have only this small little plant, and you can see it has around 10 plus buds guys. You can see here I have two, again here I have, and here I have, see here I have here, see again the small buds are coming here also. So as you can see, it has more number of buds. See, it is not like hibiscus that we'll be getting. In double petal hibiscus we won't be getting these many flowers and these many buds. So what you need to do to get these many buds and these many flowers, in hibiscus it's not like hibiscus that you'll be getting the bloom in a day or so after forming a bud, like in a day or two, but in this one it takes lot of time. Okay, so every day if you want to enjoy at least a single flower, then you have to give it proper nutrients and the soil should be very very well drained. So let's talk about this. So coming to the soil mixture guys, what we need to take the soil mix is, see, as you can see how the soil mixes, it is very very porous. It is very porous guys. See, so what you need to do, you have to take a well-drained soil mix as that of garden soil, and you have to take a cocoa peat is very very important, because as a hibiscus this one also needs a moist soil. So you have to keep the soil always moist. Okay, water it when only like a half inch of the soil is dry. Okay, so you can take 40% of garden soil, 30% cocoa peat, and again is like vermicompost you can take. You have to add good number of vermicompost guys. So when you add vermicompost, what happens is, this to form these buds, it needs energy guys to form these buds, and then again it has to become flower. It is not like the ornamental plants. Like ornamental plants, what happen if you don't give them proper nutrients also, like they don't need that much of fertilizer compared to the flowers which will be like bearing flowers or fruits. Okay, these plants which will be bearing flowers or fruits. So you have to give it rich amount of vermicompost, or you can give it cow dung compost, and every 15 days 10 to 15 days you should not forget to fertilize this plant. Okay, you should never forget. And if you want to add a chemical fertilizer, then you can spray NPK 19-19-19. One thing you have to remember is guys, you should never spray it on the, you should never put it in the soil. What happens when you put this in soil, these plants, they won't survive for the long run guys if you put lot of chemical fertilizer in this. See, this is not a plant which grows annually. Like this is a perennial plant, you will be having permanent plant. This is, yeah, in the season they'll be flowering, but the plant will be permanent. So these kind of plants, you should never put the chemical fertilizers in the soil. You should always put the chemical fertilizer up onto this, like you have to spray. What happens, these leaves, they'll absorb all the nutrients and give it to the plant. So that is a better idea. And also one more thing guys, when you spray it on the plant, what happens in the soil to absorb nutrients, it take lot of times, but when you sow it in the, when you spray it on the leaves, it take much lesser time to absorb the nutrients. So in that way, what happens is, you will even get the flowers and buds properly, and even like in faster, you know, the process which going to happen in 15 days or so will be starting in a week only. Okay, so that is the thing, guys. And watering is just see in the rainy season, like complete rainy season, this was completely put here in the rain. So it like to be watered every day, guys. Whatever you do, like every day the water will be finished. It absorbs loads of water, so you need to check it a little bit. Don't overwater it. See, if you overwater, the leaves will turn yellow. So that is a sign. If the leaf is turning yellow, then you have to stop watering for a day, again give water another day. You have to see that, keep that in mind and do. If not, there is a simple method. You can just check the soil. If you feel it this dry also, you need to water it. Okay, and coming to the sunlight, this requires at least 6 to 7 hours of sunlight, guys. Keep it on the terrace, or you can put it in a sunny place where you get around 5 to 6 hours of sunlight will do. So this requires sunlight to flower, to bud, everything. This required a lot of sunlight. Okay, and again, soil I told you, fertilizer I told you. So you can use NPK, or you can use vermicompost or cow dung compost. You can also use seaweed extract. Seaweed extract is also very good. You can just put it in the seaweed granules. You can just soak it, or you can use a liquid seaweed extract and you can spray it off. But mostly these vermicompost or cow dung compost or the kitchen waste, what you have, that will work more, very very good on this plant. See, what I use is kitchen waste. I also used the tea water, what I already mentioned in my other video. Is like you need to put the a banana peel fertilizer you can put in this, and for the tea is like the tea powder, you need to put it overnight in a half liter or 1 liter of water. Then you can double it next day and you can give it all the plants. You can give it to this plant, golden pothos also. This works really wonders. You can see how this one is growing. This one grows till it goes till the ground floor, guys. This, you can just see how beautiful these things are growing. It is the magic of the tea water, what I get. So this is it, guys. So this is how you can control the bud falling. Many people, they complain that, ma'am, you're getting good flowers, but my buds are not flowering. They just come and they will drop from here. So that is because this plant is not getting enough nutrients, or it is not getting enough sunlight. They form the bud, but it will drop off. Okay, so you have to give good number of nutrients for this kind of plants. They require good fertilization. You can give it egg peel, okay, eggs peel. You can just put it in the sunlight for some days and you can just make a powder of it and give a half spoon of it for your flowering plants. All of the flowering plants, it has loads of calcium in it. Okay, you can give little bit of Epsom salt also. But see, if you're getting good number of leaves, the leaves are green enough, you no need to give much of Epsom salt. Epsom salt is you have to give when you're not getting leaves or you're not getting buds. Okay, so don't try for Epsom salt now. For hibiscus, tea water and this vermicompost will work wonders. No need to try any other fertilizers, or you can spray NPK 19-19-19 or 20-20-20. Okay, sunlight I told you, water I told you, yeah, pot. So coming to the pot, as I in my other video also, where I have showed you like hybrid hibiscus, there also I've showed you how to take the pot in that. You can visit that video of mine. You have to always take a larger pot for the hibiscus, because the roots, they spread widely, they won't spread long enough underneath the pot. It will not go inside the pot more, it will more spread towards the sideways of the pot. So you have to take a larger container, wide container, rather than taking a long container. If you are taking a long container, if you have a long container, then take it a bigger size, because see, this size is very big for this plant. Generally, this is a 12 inch container what I have. If you have, like, if you can take just 6-7 inch would be enough, but see, I have taken 12 inch because roots will, so in that way it will give you more number of blooms. And one more thing is, underwatering this plant may lead to the stress to the plant, and also it drops its buds. So you know, should always check on the watering, guys. You should water it every day, or at least if you are living in a very colder region, then you have to water it alternate day at least, so that it won't drop its buds and the plant doesn't go in stress. What happens if the plant go in the stress again and again, it leaves droop. What happens is, it won't be flowering or giving, you know, everyday process what he has to do, it will stop. So for that to continue, what you need to do is, you have to pour water every day, guys, or else like, don't let the plant to go into the stress. Make it a routine and do it, because if these go into stress and don't do everyday routine, so there will be, like, you can see I don't have any pests on my plant. See how beautiful they are growing. I don't have any pests, because see, if the plant is healthy, the pests won't attack also. Okay, so that also is a reason. And coming to the pest attack, as you all know, mealybug and aphids attack these plants. Mostly the hibiscus attacked by mealybugs. You have these nasty creatures, they reach everywhere. So I'm going to do a video also on mealybugs, how to remove mealybugs. I've done the video, I'll be doing that video, and I'll be sharing with you guys. You have to mix 4 to 5 ml of neem oil with hand wash, what you have, Dettol hand wash, or any other, like if you have shampoo, you can just take a little bit of liquid soap solution, that in 1 to 3 ml of soap solution in 1 liter of water, shake them together and give it to the plants. These mealybugs, they'll go off. So in every 15 to 20 days you need to do that compulsorily. On hibiscus definitely you have to do that, so that no bugs can attack. And these mealybugs, they hate the smell of this neem oil and they won't get near to the plant. Okay, so here I end my video, guys. If you like my video, please hit a like button and please subscribe my channel. If you like these kind of plants, grow more and more plants, share it with your friends, share these plants. These can also grow with the cuttings, guys. I'll be doing a video on the cutting of the hibiscus, because I have planted recently some hibiscus plants of mine. I have propagated double petal. I'll show that with you. I'll show that to you. And also, I'm going to make a video on how to propagate the hibiscus. So that also I'll be sharing with you guys. Okay. So guys, thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe my channel and grow these kind of plants. They look lovely. Okay, thank you guys, bye.